Dear student, in this video, we are going to watch the types of furnaces. After watching this video, learner will be able to describe the construction and working of given furnaces. So, when you are going to watch, after complete watching this video, you can write the construction and working of the given furnace. So first we will see the types of furnaces. So types of furnaces, depending on the mode of heat generation. Okay, how you are going to generate the heat? Actually furnace it is used for the heating purpose. Okay, so how you are going to generate the heat, and depending upon that mode of generation of heat, furnaces are mainly two type. One is combustion type and other is the electric type. Okay, so first we are going to see combustion type. Combustion type means what? Where heat is generated by using the fuel in these furnaces. Okay, when heat is generated by using the fuel like your coal, okay, or any other fuel like wood or bagasse, it is used as a fuel and heat is generated, that type of furnace, it is called the combustion type furnace. Okay. And next, second type, that is the electric type, where heating is done by electrically heating element. Okay, means a muffle furnace or your hot air oven, which is present in our lab, all that are the electric type oven. Means where heating is done when you are going to switch on the button, but electric means when you are going to generate the heat, that furnace we are going to call it as a electric type furnace. Let us proceed further. So first we are going to see the combustion type furnace, blast furnace. It is the example of combustion type furnace. Okay, see, this is the image of blast furnace. In your school also you have studied about the blast furnace. This blast furnace mostly used for the extraction of metal. This blast furnace, it is divided into mostly three parts. This is the upper one, it is called the throat. This is the throat. Middle one is the body, and lower one, it is called the hearth. Hearth, H-E-A-R-T-H, hearth, or it is also called well of furnace. Well of furnace. Okay, so it is divided into the three part. First one, it is the throat. Okay, this is your throat. This is not your throat. This is the blast furnace throat. This is middle is the body. And below the body and above the hearth, there are the number of pipes are available. Okay, and that pipe, it is called the wires. It is called the wires through which hot dry air is blown inside. Okay, so this is the blast furnace. Okay, here you can see the structure. Like here is a like crane like structure is here. Here charge is fed in this. The charge means it consists of your ore, limestone and coke. It is mixed thoroughly, and here through this throat it is fed into this furnace. Okay, at the mouth of the furnace, it is provided with the cup and cone arrangement. Cup and cone means, okay, see, this is your cup like and this is your cone structure. Okay, that cone, it is provided with the chain, iron chain, continuous long iron chain is there. Okay, when you want to pour this charge, that time this cone is closed, and here it is going to, here the charge is coming here. When you are going to lower this chain, lower that iron chain, that time that charge, it is fed into that furnace. Okay, and immediately after that, it is pulled up to close the mouth of that. Why this cup and cone arrangement is there? To avoid the exit of this hot gases outside the furnace. Okay, here it is very hot, it is red hot, temperature is very high in this blast furnace. So to avoid the entry of that hot gases outside the furnace, this cup and cone arrangement is there at the top of furnace. Okay, so here first part, it is the throat, middle is the body, this is the body of the furnace. Okay, and bottom, this part, it is called the hearth or well of furnace. that hearth or well of furnace, it is having the two opening, okay? One is at the top and other is at the bottom. Through this top, slag is removed, okay? Here, slag is removed. Already we have seen, what is slag? What is slag? Slag, it is nothing but the gang plus flux. Gang plus flux, it is called the slag. And here slag, which is lighter in weight, which is going to form above that molten metal. Here it is your molten metal. Above the molten metal, that slag is formed, which is fusible. Fusible means in molten state. It is the combination of gang and flux. It is removed through this top opening. Okay, through this top opening, slag is removed. And through that bottom opening, molten metal is there. Okay, here molten metal is taken out. Okay, and this is the twire. Hot air is taken inside. This is called the twire. This is body. This is the throat. And in the throat or at the mouth of that blast furnace, it is provided with the double cup and cone arrangement. Okay, so blast furnace, it is which type of furnace? It is a combustion type furnace. Remember, blast furnace, it is the combustion type furnace. Combustion means here heat is generated by using the fuel. Which fuel is used here? Coke. Coke is used as a fuel for the generation of heat in blast furnace. Now we are going to see the construction of this blast furnace. See here, already I said to you, height of that blast furnace, it is a 20 to 30 meter high. The height of that blast furnace, it is a 20 to 30 meter high, 4 to 8 meter wide. It is 4 to 8 meter wide, like this. Okay, at widest part, it is known as Bosch. Here it is the widest part, it is known as the Bosch. Okay, next, it is divided into four parts. Okay, first one is the throat. You can see this is the throat. Middle one is the body. Here it is called the Bosch. It is the wider part, it is called the Bosch. And here bottom is the hearth. Okay, top of the furnace, double cup and cone arrangement to prevent escaping out gases from the furnace. Already I said to you in previous slide, here at the top it is provided with the double cup and cone arrangement to avoid or escaping the hot gases from out inside to the outside. Okay, to avoid the to prevent the escaping of that hot gases from the furnace to outside. Okay, near the top there is an outlet for the flue gases. You can see at the top here, you can see there is one opening. It is for the flue gases, means waste gases is there. Okay, at about 2.5 meter above the base from the furnace, there is a series of tubes called twires. Here from the 2.5, from the base, number of tubes are here. Number of tubes are there, that series of tubes, it is called the twires. And through that twires, hot blast of air, dry hot blast air is taken inside, okay, for the heating purpose. Next, at the base, at the base there are the two outlets. You can see here, one is at the top, which is for the slag. From this top opening, slag is removed. Already as shown you in this previous image also, this is opening for the slag. And from the bottom opening, here molten metal is removed from that lower outlet. Okay, and up from the top outlet, slag is removed. So this is about the blast furnace. Next type of furnace, that is muffle furnace. Okay, muffle furnace, or it is also called the retort furnace. Which type of furnace it is? You can see whether we are going to heat by using any fuel here. You are going to coal, put the coal here and you are going to heat this? No. So here it is the, by you are going to generate the heat by electric mean. So this muffle furnace, it is the example of which type of furnace? Electric type furnace. It is an electric type furnace. You can see here at the top, here it is a temperature controller is here. This is temperature controller. In our lab also you can see this muffle furnace temperature controller is at the top. Here is a safety door. Here switch is there for operator safety. This is the safety door. You can see when you are going to open that door, it is like this. Okay, very small chamber is there. Okay, like brick size it is there only. Now, back side of that, there is a one ventilated heating chamber. Ventilated means you can, hot gas, vented heating chamber is there. Means, if to pass the air through this vented, one slight small window is there. Okay, so this is the image of that muffle furnace. You can see in our lab also it is available. Next, construction. Construction, see what it consists of. First, a vented heating chamber is there, backside, small window like is there, pass the air through it. Temperature controller at the top of that muffle furnace, just now I have shown you. Door safety switch for the operator safety. Okay, for operator safety, it is a door safety switch is there. Okay, the temperature of that muffle furnace is very high, near about 900 to 1200 degrees Celsius, the temperature of that muffle furnace is. Okay, working temperature is like this. So, to take the precaution or for the operator safety, door safety switch is there. Okay, next, what are the advantages of that? More consistent product properties. Okay, because equal heating is there. So, what to say, means whatever the product we are getting, it is having the everywhere it is having the same property, consistent product properties you are going to get from the muffle furnace. Faster heating rate, okay, as you are heating here by using the electric melt, so heating is faster as compared to your combustion type furnace. Okay, next, more stable operating conditions, means stably you can operate this, all these condition, means you can set the temperature, but in combustion type furnace it is not easily possible to handle or to control that condition, when temperature or any other thing, it is not easily regulated in the combustion type furnace. But in electric furnace, it is easily maintained or easily operated. Okay, less fuel consumption is there. Here, less fuel is required, but there more fuel is required. Here, in muffle furnace, less pollution is there. But in combustion type, flue gases are more, so it is going to pollute your environment. So, this is about the types of furnaces. Okay, thank you.